Well, good evening, everybody, and welcome. What is it tonight? It's a groundbreaking show because we have our first woman, we have our first young person, and as you can see, Julia Stuart joins me, who I know very well from Supersport. I haven't worked with her for many years. I'm remembering to look at the green dot now, Julia. Welcome to Locked Down Discs. How are you?
Great, thank you. I'm also trying to look at the green dot. It's a very new venture for both of us. I'm usually across from you. Now I'm looking at a green dot and not at your face, which is what I'm tempted to do. And I do feel like I'm on TV, actually, just hearing the voice. I watched your lockdown discs and immediately felt like I had Supersport 3 on. And yeah, it was taking me back to those glorious days of just being able to go to work, right? Tough times all around. Keeping the spirits up.
If you watched the one with Terry Payne, I'm sure you would have had Monday Night Football flashbacks.
Yes. I was quite enjoying Terry, the way he was looking at the must have been so strange for him, all new territory for all of us.
Well, as you would have seen, he kept disappearing lower and lower and lower, and I kept saying to him, raise it up, but we gave up. I must say, my wife and I took 50 minutes to educate him just to get online, but we managed to do it. Just very quickly, before we start with your lockdown disc, just to remind folks who might be watching, particularly those who are following Jules for the first time and don't know what it's about, this is basically the old Desert Island Disc. So what I'm doing is I'm putting Julia into lockdown, and I've told her she can only take 5 songs. That's all. She can take 5 songs with her into lockdown, 2 movies and a book. And we've seen with show 2 with Pommy, you battled to narrow it down, which is understandable because I'm sure if anybody out there was asked to take 5 songs, it's not easy, but that's part of it. And of course, Jules will explain why. But before we get into that, Jules, you're actually in Cape Town, hey, with your family. So everybody safe and staying strong and practicing the lockdown, which is great.
And staying indoors, which is the most important thing. Yes, I did manage to, after we did a public service announcement advert about coronavirus, some of us in the football industry, that same day, I was summoned home by the family. And so I've been here since before lockdown. They're good moments and bad moments. I won't expose anybody on here for whatever reason. Just to say that I'm very happy to be with family. I'm very happy I don't have to cook every night. And we are healthy and staying safe. That's the most important thing. And since you asked about my family, you have to give us an update on your family.
Oh, well, hopefully you won't hear my family during the course of it. So far, we've done well. I record, as you know, late at night, so the kids are safely locked up. But my third guest, Shimmy, last night has got a 3-month-old daughter, and I've got a 3-month-old son. So we were comparing notes before going on, but everybody's good. Everybody's thriving, and that's the most important thing. Well, Jules, let's get on to your selections because, and first of all, I'm going to say, I mentioned early on, it's a slightly different show because you're younger and it's a revelation. No disrespect to some of the previous guests, but they went for sort of older songs, less trendy songs. Yeah. There is a trend that runs through yours. It sounds to me like if you go into lockdown, you're going to have one hell of a party. There's going to be a lot of dancing going on.
Definitely. Listen, I am all about keeping the positivity and keeping the energy up. That has gotten me through our lockdown so far. It's easy to think you're in a position of privilege because you have people around you, you have electricity, you've got Wi-Fi, you have food. So what is there to complain about? But we are human, and it's very important to understand that everybody has their own things that they deal with. So positivity is a big part of who I am, and it's a big part of what's getting me through the current lockdown we're in. So for your lockdown task, it was very easy for me to choose songs that were going to get me up and going in the morning, get me motivated to work out. And there's one song in there which is based on real life experience of this lockdown, which is a song that we've been singing at karaoke every Saturday night in-house lockdown.
Well, let's start with that song. Which one of the 5 is it?
Yes. Bohemian Rhapsody.
Okay. Great movie, of course. It sort of got a new life because it won all the Oscars and so forth. And it's a long song, so I'm going to play a little bit of it, obviously. But I'm actually going to be quiet at the start because, as you know, we could actually fill this entire podcast with probably Queen's version of it, because it is fairly long. So let me press this. Julia Stuart's first selection, a song we all know, and it has certainly stood the test of time. It's Bohemian Rhapsody. Obviously the live version. I'm going to start singing now. What is it about the Bohemian Rhapsody song? Let me just pause it for a moment. That actually make you chose it because of what's going on right now for you in lockdown?
Well, because I love singing. Mm. I grew up in performing arts, and a huge part of me is going to need something to belt out in lockdown. Can I just add, my imaginary lockdown that you put me in takes place on a wonderful deserted island. So that's where I've put myself. And that's why all the songs are also like good mood songs. This one, we have actually got a little lockdown tradition going in the family. We do a braai every Saturday, and then we put on karaoke. My cousin does all this, she picks the songs. And we chose this one on the first night, and it's gone every week. It's been in the playlist every week. So even if I was by myself, it would remind me of the family. Also, it's just a great song. There's so many elements to it. You know, you could get on the uppity part, or get on the kind of more singy part, or the crazy part. I mean, yeah, let's leave it there.
And as I say, stood the test of time. Here it is. This is the live version. You can sing along if you want.
Against his hand. Now he's dead. Mama. I'm not singing, it's going to embarrass me.
What a voice, eh? Freddie Mercury. Another thing that's been interesting, that having done just a couple of these already, is that there's already this underlying trend that you can see, that everybody without fail takes somebody who has just got such a distinctive voice. So whether it be Terry going for Frank Sinatra, Shimmy with Hugh Masekela, and somebody actually that you've got in common with Pommy will come up later, but Freddie Mercury, just unbelievably unmistakable.
The greats. You don't need to know the song, you don't need to hear a lot of it. Once the person sings maybe one or two words, you know it's that person. And I always think that is a mark of a great artist, a memorable artist, an artist who is going to stand the test of time. I mean, if you played a couple notes of Whitney Houston, a couple notes of whoever that we consider greats and timeless, you would know within three words who that person is.
Okay, so no surprise there. I think that song is like...
I was hoping you were going to play the end part.
If we run out of things to say, we can end off the last 7 minutes of the show with the rest of the song, but there's lots to go. So we've got movies and stuff to go.
Yes.
But you're right. It's almost an opera within the song, isn't it? I mean, it has so many...
Yes.
...to it. You're right.
Yeah,
lovely. Okay, next song. What's your second song, Jules?
Just trying to think what I picked.
I picked
a Drake song.
Okay, the Drake song, yes.
I picked a Drake song. I picked early Drake. It's off one of his first albums, 2010. Hmm. It came out. Drake has been one of the standouts of this kind of era of music, of my generation. He just, the things he speaks about and the turn of phrase. I know you don't have Instagram, but if you did, a lot of people's captions pretty much come from Drake's songs these days, the last couple of years. There's so many Drake songs I could have picked, so many that apply to a lot of different situations. And rap music and hip hop music. There are a lot of other artists who I could have picked, Jay-Z, loads and loads of others. I just think Drake has been... he's been one of the most influential, and he's certainly been standout in my life. There's certain songs who I associate with certain people, good friend of mine, you know, nights out, when you come home late at night, there's a Drake lyric for pretty much everything that you've gone through.
Well, this is where I saw the party trend starting, because the moment I put it on, I saw that I could visualize that there's going to be a bit of dancing going on. I wasn't familiar. I'm obviously familiar with Drake. I wasn't familiar with the song, but I can see why you chose it, and it's got an interesting lyric. So the song you've chosen is Over. Does it have any, apart from the beat and Drake, does it have any other significance for you?
The words, you know, I've spoken already about positivity, and he says, this is his life. That's what he's going to do till it's over. And it's far from over, you know, I'm living life. I'm doing me. I love that, man. I love it. It's a vibe, as they say.
Well, as I say, when I heard it, I said, I'm not surprised Julia Stuart chose this one. So here it is. This is Drake, Over. And Julia was quick to remind me it had to be the clean version. So this is the
I know way too many people here right now that I didn't know last year. Who the are y'all? Last few nights we've been everywhere and back, but I just can't remember it all. Remember it all. What am I doing? What am I doing? I'm doing me. Yeah. You need to learn the song, Neil. You need to learn the song. When the lockdown is over, I'm coming to your house. We're gonna jam to the song.
It's another interesting song, and I can see why people would want to take that. It has its own vibe, its own message, and as I say, there was a lot of Julia Stuart going on in that lyric. I doing me was something I could see why you would take. So Jules, I mean, you've had, I mean, just speaking of you personally in your career and so forth, it continues to blossom. You must be delighted the way things are going, and life at Supersport and beyond. Exciting times for you, eh?
I mean, it's so strange to talk about it now because sport doesn't really matter. Given the current situation and given why we are doing this interview via Zoom. But yeah, I've had a good year, I think. And what this time's also given me is an opportunity to kind of look at the way I present and the way in which I have grown and how I want to grow. And so I've done a little bit of study on kind of my presenting skills. I'm reading a book and trying to just work on it, because you can get so lost in live sport. I mean, Neil, you know this, it just feels a little bit silly to be telling you this, but you can get so lost in live sport that you don't stop and take stock. You don't stop and appreciate and applaud and acknowledge what you have just done or what you've been able to do. So for example, you'd have worked on the Rugby World Cup, which was massive. Did you, after that, do you stop and think? No, you don't really. You just carry on and you do the next thing. And so this period has been one of just acknowledging, damn, I've actually come a long way. So watched a really old tape of mine from when I just started out, to acknowledge that, you know, where I've grown and what I still want to work on. But yeah, I mean, you'd know, you were there in the early days when I started working at Supersport. It's my fifth year now, at Supersport. So yeah, it's been some story, hey, some journey.
Yeah, it's been great. It's been meteoric, and you know, you are a lot of people's, I wouldn't say favorite, but we love working with you. I mean, Terry will tell you that all the time, and that's always a compliment when you have people to work with that enjoy working with you. I think at Supersport we're very much blessed with that. Actually can't think of anybody that I don't like working with, so it's a great environment. But congratulations on that. With regards to me stopping and taking stock, if I stopped at my age, I wouldn't start again, so I've got to keep going. Those muscles just...
one thing
One thing
I wanted to say, which is so important, something that you spoke about us all being the kind of relationships we all have to have. I was talking to one of the coaches in one of the Instagram lives I was doing, and I was saying a lot of people don't realize we spend so much time together, especially those of us who work pitch side. You travel, you you know, you stay in hotels together. It's so important for us to have those kinds of relationships with each other. And so, yeah, I mean, I love Terry. I actually haven't called him in a while, so I think I'm gonna call him tomorrow.
Yeah, well, you, like, you know, you time probably, now, right? As I say, you're one of his favorites, so he'll certainly welcome that call for sure. Okay, song number three. We're going now, well, you tell me, is this the Dancing Again song? Is that where we're going next?
We can.
Yes. Tell me a bit about Dance. Now, this I didn't know at all. I don't know the artist. I didn't know the song, but I loved it. The moment I listened to it, I'm glad I've downloaded it because I can play it in my own car. But tell us a little bit about why you're taking Dancing Again. And who's the artist? Do you call him Timo or Timo? Timo?
It's Timo ODV.
Okay. Tim?
Timo. Timo. Timo ODV. Okay. Timo. Timo. Timo Odi, yeah, that's the thing that they do with, like, Ultra and wherever he plays, yeah.
Okay, so let's play it. For those that don't know, I'm sure everybody's saying, oh, Neil, don't be so old. But anyway, here we go. This is...
Need the beat to drop.
Another dance song from Julia. It's an ideal castaway lockdown song, really, because the lyrics is also saying how long before we are dancing again. That's a good question. to watch our president. It's a nice upbeat song. I think, like many of us, we're very blessed in South Africa to have a government and a president who's leading from the front. So some of it's been, obviously it's tough to take, but you know, I don't know about you, but I feel that the leadership has been great in the country, which makes everything, the lockdown, that much easier.
Listen, you know, football fans have great humor and banter, and people were saying, we're not putting him on the transfer list after this, our president. He's not going to get transferred to any other country because the leadership has been superb. I've watched some of the other train wrecks in live TV no press conferences. Mentioned. Oh, it has been shocking. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's been really shocking. So feeling very blessed that the leadership has been decisive, has been considerate of a lot of different factors, and just feeling well led, because this country, I mean, if they didn't act very quickly, we you know, who knows what would have happened.
Yeah, so, absolutely. Yeah. Okay, so now let's do the movies. You tell me both your movies that you've taken, and how difficult was it?
Well, I think you missed the Timo ODV. I didn't really explain about that. Okay. And then you missed Beyonce. How can you miss Beyonce?
No. I'm coming back to that. I always do a couple of music ones first, then the movie, then we go back to it. But if you want to explain Dancing Again, yes.
Yes. So that's one of my gym songs.
Ah.
So it has a dual, like, it's a vibe. Because in this lockdown, your fictitious lockdown,
yes,
there's alcohol, right? Like, there's drinks.
Hang on, let me just have a sip of this gin and let me decide whether you're...
Oh.
You know, I'm like playing the guy on the
icon. We have lots of gin here, by the way. My mom belonged to Gin of the Month Club, so she had stored up. So we are well looked after here. But your lockdown...
I'm not locked down. You're locked down. And I've just got a message from some guy called Cyril saying, no, there's no alcohol for you, no, especially after the song.
But on my deserted island lockdown that you've put me on,
well,
there's definitely alcohol, right?
Okay, we'll give you... I let Pommy, like, have seven songs, so I'll give you a bit of alcohol.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Can't believe I had to negotiate fake alcohol for a fake island lockdown. New levels.
So these new two levels. Movies, what about the two movies?
Yes. Yeah, so I chose, same as I did with Bohemian Rhapsody, time was a factor.
Mm.
So the longer the movie, I figured the more it could keep me entertained.
Okay.
Yeah. So the one I chose was Avengers Endgame. The movies are actually harder to choose than the songs because although I don't watch a lot of series and so on, I actually studied film and media. So part of my degree, undergrad, was film. Okay. So we studied things like Nosferatu, those kinds of movies. Mm. So the movies was really, really difficult to choose. So I went for time. Mm. And I went for movies that I could watch over and over and find something new every time. And Marvel movies, I'm such a Marvel, like I cried in Avengers Endgame a few times. And this one is obviously the culmination of phase one of Marvel, and it's the end of the Avengers, and they have to go and try and find the guy who wiped out the entire world. That's Thanos. I don't know how well you know Marvel, so that's why I'm just explaining it to you. You see, I know you. I knew you were lost.
So I missed that generation. Yeah, I grew up with clangers. That's about it. But obviously, my kids are some of those Marvel characters. Yes. And Hloplo, my wife, is a big Avengers fan. So
yes, yeah. But we should have subbed her in for this one. We should have subbed her in for this chat because I feel like with Drake and with Avengers, and she, it might have been, might have been more her vibe.
You're right. That's been Marvel, all of the guests. I think she's had more in those guests than she has with her husband. But I understand that. Avengers you're taking, okay? And then
yes, but Avengers Endgame because. Okay. I wanted to choose a comedy, maybe White Chicks or Nacho Libre, thinking if I'm in lockdown, I'm going to need something to make me laugh. But that kind of gets old really quickly after you watch it a couple of times, whereas Avengers, because there's so many different parts to it, and it's 3 hours and 2 minutes, 12 minutes, I can't remember. We'd have to ask Simo. But there's so many different things. So you could watch Avengers one time and only watch Spider-Man, or you could watch Avengers and only watch Thanos, or you could watch Avengers and only watch Captain America. So if I'm going to be in this fake lockdown where you're limiting my alcohol and you're only giving me two movies, that's the movie I'm going to take.
Okay, yeah. Right.
Plus, there's good humor in there. There's really good humor.
So plenty of logic and a lot of thought given to that movie. Now, the other one is the 2010 movie Inception, which is a great movie. Yes. Tell us why Inception.
Because I want to know if the top stops spinning at the end or not. I'm going to watch it until I have the answer. That's why I chose it. Yeah. Again, Inception has, it's a long movie. It's multifaceted. It's fascinating. And also, Neil, full disclosure, both of those movies, Avengers and Inception, have major candy. I mean, you put me on lockdown, so what must I do? I've got to have something to look at.
What are you talking about, Leonardo?
Like everybody, there's Captain America, there's Iron Man, there is
both Thor. Of them. Okay,
Thor in Avengers Endgame isn't hot because he's fat, like he literally is like in the beard, and so not Thor, but
I'm looking at Tom Hardy. I'm looking at a guy called Ken Watanabe now, who's no oil painting, Ken. But there you go. He was in Inception. Okay.
There's all of them. There's lots of hot guys in both. So eye candy, length, and mental figure out ability. I just made up a new word right here. On lockdown.
Yes, anything goes. You're on lockdown. If you've got alcohol, people will understand. Okay, so now we've got one song remaining. We've got, what about the book? What about the book? Before we do, you've already leaked that it's a Beyoncé song. What book did you decide on? Was that difficult?
Oh, this was so difficult because I am a big reader. You can put me in lockdown with like 10 books, no songs, no movies, and I'll be just fine. So I'm really big on reading. Which book did I eventually choose, actually?
I'll have to go and have a look. I mean, I was hoping you'd remember. I know you did say there were plenty to choose. I can check.
I mean, even narrowing it down. Hold on. I have it here.
Okay.
Oh, I went for Fever Pitch.
Yes.
I mean, Fever Pitch is the Nick Hornby classic. It's basically like the Arsenal fans' favorite.
Yeah, sorry about that.
So then.
You're sorry about that WhatsApp I sent you the other day saying that Arsenal are giving free tickets away, and then people said they've already had enough punishment. Don't go post that. Yeah. Not surprisingly, I've seen about 10 versions back, yeah. And people had just changed it yes. to them, so I knew it was good.
I've seen about 10 versions, yeah. I've seen a few in the group.
Exactly.
So I'll choose FIFA Pitch because then you could kind of, I mean, I'm a big football fan, obviously, mm. and FIFA Pitch is Arsenal related, written by Nick Hornby. I think I mentioned that. So it would allow me to kind of relive, you know, the Michael Thomas winning at Anfield.
Yes.
That game is in there. That's basically the climax of the book. A lot of Arsenal moments in there, a lot of good football stuff in there. But the other books I also had were, for example, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows. It's the last of the Harry Potter franchise. They split it into two movies. I love Harry Potter.
Mm.
Like, I grew up, my stepmom, my two sisters and I would go and get the books at midnight at exclusives. We'd stand in the queue all dressed up. And we'd get the books and read them. And at that point, only my stepmom and I could read. So we'd read them by the fire, like in school holidays.
Yeah,
so I'd probably pick the last one, same reason, because it brings everything to an end.
Okay, two nice books. We've got one song left. And I'm going to speed it up because I've never been on Zoom long enough for the meeting to be cancelled. So I don't want to have to talk to you again tomorrow night.
You can extend it, man.
No, I don't know how to do that. But what I do know is that Beyonce, yes. I mean, this is a real upbeat yes. song. It's got Julia Stuart over it. Yes.
But can you play the end part? Because I asked you to get the extended version.
Yeah, I've got the extended one. So, but no, I don't know whether I can.
So play like towards the end.
Okay. Well, tell us then why. So this is Beyonce, Get Me Bodied, the extended version. And while Julia tells you, I will try and move towards the end of the song. Yeah, tell me why.
Shall I play it?
Have you got it?
Well, I would have to find it first.
Yeah, you'd
I'm
have
sure
to find
I've got it on my
you'd
phone.
Have to get to the end. It's fine. Tell us why.
Yes. So, Get Me Bodied is another upbeat song. I am a huge Beyonce fan. And that song, pretty much like all of the other ones, is such a great vibe, such an amazing dance track. And actually at the end, she has a couple of verses that tell you what to do. So it's like, do the scissor legs, touch your heel, touch your toe. So it's a dance.
Okay, I'm gonna try and get it forward. I think I went forward to certainly the song. Is she telling us what to do yet? Okay, I'm fast forwarding it a little bit.
Is that play there? Wind it back. That's what she's saying. Touch your back, girl. Shake it like that, and I can't. Touch your knees, touch your back, girl. Shake it like that, and I can't.
She does a lot of shaking of her butt generally in her career.
Yeah.
I think I've gone too much now, you see. Okay, so there we go.
That is not Beyonce.
Sorry, now we've gone to completely another song. But yeah, the energy, I can imagine just purely from the energy that'll keep you occupied.
Anybody in Cape Town or Johannesburg who's ever seen me in a club will know when it's Beyonce, it's the moment. Like, it's a thing.
I'm trying to remember. I know my wife and I went clubbing with you in Cape Town. I've been on therapy ever since. I can't remember if Beyonce was played that night, but I'll take the word.
Not at that club. No, not at that club.
Jules, the last thing that I want to close off with, it's been great fun. As I say, I think it's a younger vibe. It's certainly an extended vibe you've given of all the refreshing. I'm going back to a couple more old fogies tomorrow. So it's been refreshing. But I think the last word, maybe just to ask you, you know, to send a message out to all South Africans, because we've still got a bit of our own genuine lockdown still to go. And we started off by talking about people being responsible and making sure that they follow instructions. And it's important, and no sense in taking our foot off the pedal now.
Yeah. I think what I can't wrap my head around is that people see this as an inconvenience, or we think we should just be allowed to go to the movies, or we should just, it doesn't make any sense. We are staying home to save lives. That's it. It's as simple as that. Those of us who can are staying home to help those who wouldn't be able to survive the coronavirus. The immune compromised portion of our population needs our support right now. I want to encourage people to give where they can. And I'm not saying give money. I'm saying if there's someone around, you know, who can't afford just a meal or anything you can do in a little way. We really need that spirit of Ubuntu to come through strong right now. And then just finally, I've got two doctors in my immediate family who are both working. One is working in the hospital, the other in a clinic. And this is very real for us, given some members of our family have lung issues. So I just want to say to them, to all our essential workers right now, that you are doing your country duty. We know it's difficult times. Sometimes you don't even have the right protective gear. But what you are doing is so important, and we so value you, and we are so thankful for the job you are doing for your communities, for the country as a whole. And to our government, keep making those important decisions. You're not going to please everybody, but it's got to be done.
Julia Stuart, beautiful. Thank you. It's a wonderful way to end your lockdown discs. It's kept us excited. It's kept us fit. And we hope that you enjoy it. And yes, you do have a little bit of alcohol. We'll chat to you soon. Thanks, Julia Stuart.
Thank you so much, Neil. Thanks for having me.
Bye-bye.